This film depicts the respectful yet graphic steps involved in transforming a freshly killed deer into steaks, sausage, and roasts. Mid-November in Maine, I shot a male white-tailed deer in a field on my property. I used my old tractor and trailer to bring it up to the woodshed where I would hang it for a few days to cure. My good friend Tom came over that evening to show me how to skin and trim a deer. He has endless experience in this, and it still took us several hours. Sharp knives facilitated us working the hide down off of the carcass. I was astonished at the plainly beautiful packaging of muscles and tendons hidden beneath the skin. Visceral bundles of boundless potential energy. Coiled biological springs evolved to evade with stealth and power. Luke Stone traveled from the dark green hollows of Vermont to butcher the deer with me 5 days later. He's a fine chef and a good friend. Hi, Luke. We proceeded to spend the first few hours breaking down the deer with a variety of tools, both primitive and modern. This is not the first deer Luke has sunk a blade into, and his experience was amazing. We've more or less quartered the animal here, and now we'd begin breaking it down into smaller, more manageable pieces, which we'll bring into the warmth of my kitchen by the wood stove. The bandsaw proved effective cutting through the shank. And the sawzall made very short work of these massively thick and decadent tenderloin steaks.
You may need to invest in one of these.
All right. So basically we cut all the rest into roasts, I think.
Cool.
Or those types of meat and take the scrap, add it to that and have enough for...
Plus I got a bag of scrap in there.
Plus you got a bag of scrap in there. So we'd have enough for basically... A 6 pound batch of one sausage, 7 pound batch of one sausage, 7 pound batch of one sausage.
You just ride right along with the snake.
And then, like, a perfect four.
Yeah.
Just kind of like tap it and pull.
Like this?
Yeah.
A little bit of a butcher job in there, but that's alright.
Yeah, no. And the what's working against you is the freezing nice. Right now. I mean, normally they just...
Peel off.
Peel right off.
I mean, we're there. Oh my god. Look at that, huh?
Yeah, so then you'll start seeing the muscles. And then basically, when you get that, separate that. Set it off aside, and those are going to be like the cuts that you freeze to then cut into steaks, right? Okay. So, like, I can't remember. I think that's the bottom round. This one's the eye of the round. This should peel right off. That's you go down through there.
God damn.
Yeah, and you can cut that in half to freeze it, you know?
Luke brought with him this industrial strength meat grinder and a plethora of fancy spices for making three varieties of sausage. Here we are doing the second and finer grind for the 6-pound venison bologna. He also brought with him this handy sausage stuffer, along with both hog and beef casings. No one has ever made any kind of joke during this process in the history of sausage making, I can assure you. Once stuffed, I tied it off and set it aside to rest. I par cooked it a couple days later. Et voila! I cooked the steak for us over the coals of the wood stove. Luke made an outrageous sauce from the simmering scrap pot, finished with cranberries and butter. Perfectly rare and tender. Here Luke mixes in by hand all the spices, the garlic and fresh bay leaves, into the sausage. He's cleaning out the hog casings.
But you can kind of crank like that.
This takes patience and timing, and he clearly has both in spades, as he has made countless links of forced meat in his career as a butcher and chef. He makes this look a lot easier than it is. I'm rolling out the dough for the meat pie we would be making. It's more of a way to contain the meat as it cooks than a flaky traditional pie crust.
Go right on like that.
The breakfast of champions. Fresh sausage and sunny side up eggs. The meat pie, once out of the oven. Served cold with pickles and mustard. My mouth waters at the thought a year later. I'm hanging the two varieties of sausage here to cure in the woodshed for a couple days. I would then also parboil them and freeze them in pairs. Not only did I have a freezer full of healthy meat and bone broth, but the invaluable experience that will never get consumed.